not wait. I hope members will not again disappoint the public. Thank you. I object to the motion.
Yeah.
Mr. Christopher Zhang. Mr. Deputy, I speak to oppose Dr. Lung Ka-lau's motion of adjournment because I believe his adjournment motion is just a way to buy time and so as to sabotage the medical registration amendment bill. He only cares for the interests of his own sector with no regard for the interests of patients and community. This is extremely selfish and emotional. He has entirely betrayed the trust and respect patients have for doctors. Mr. Zhang, please sit down first. Dr. Leung Ka-lau, Mr. Deputy, a point of order. Can you please call for quorum?
John Fung Yu.
Mr. Christopher Zhang. But what is even more disappointing is some pan-democrats are blindly supporting this adjournment motion so as to sabotage the bill which represent the wish of many people in the community. This goes to show that they only they take things as personal. Anything that can discredit the government's authority, they're willing to do it. Yes, they say that the blue bill is controversial, and they say that it hasn't gone through due discussion, and therefore they support this motion to adjourn. I think they are not convincing enough. For members who propose this adjournment debate, I'd like to ask him what reforms would be non-controversial. Whether it be the universal retirement protection scheme or standard working hours, aren't they just as controversial if whenever there are arguments, the bill should be shelved, then the government may as well remain idle. Whenever we come across controversies, we shelve things, then Hong Kong will not have any reform or progress. Any reform is bound to touch on the interests of stakeholders, and this bill is no exception. Doctors want to protect their, so to speak, golden rice bowl, and they want to block the passage of the bill, and this is understandable. The crux of the matter is how we can strike the right balance. I understand that this is easier said than done, but so long as stakeholders are willing to engage in a rational debate, legislators are willing to come to a decision after a rational discussion, then the problem can be resolved. Asking for a call of quorum and moving an adjournment motion will only waste precious time. Ka-lau and some pan-democrats claim that the bill hasn't gone through sufficient discussion and they want to adjourn this debate. I think they are most hypocritical and pretentious. If Dr. Leung really wants a thorough discussion, there will be no need for him to repeatedly ask for a call of quorum, and there is no need for him to interrupt members' speeches using this call for quorum bell. His so-called thorough discussion is really an excuse to sabotage the bill. Pan-democrats claim that the bill would affect the professional autonomy of the medical council. They're worried that the CEO would use this as a tool to manipulate the medical council, and he may use it as a way to introduce doctors from the mainland in particular to practice in Hong Kong. I think such accusations are ungrounded. If the bill receives a second reading debate, I will refute these accusations one by one to show you how ridiculous and ungrounded they are. Some pan-democrats would like to politicize this bill, which would benefit the community, because they know that everyone wants the bill to be passed in order to improve patients' rights. They understand that if they oppose the bill openly, then they would lose the support of the people. So they would just resort to all means to politicize the bill. They call their own selfish act a way to defend professional autonomy. They demonize the bill, accusing the CEO of controlling the medical council and using this to pave the way for introduction of mainland trained doctors into Hong Kong. Because they dare not anger the people, but they would like to counter the government and attack the CE. I won't launch any personal attack, but in the last two council sittings, Dr. Ka-lau has been crazily calling for quorum, and this is unimaginable. He has totally lost or tarnished the professional image of doctors. This is a very saddening. Dr. Leung is a doctor, but he has no regard for the aspirations and interests of patients. This is most disappointing. I sincerely hope that Dr. Leung can understand that unreasonable opposition would only escalate conflicts. Only a rational debate can resolve the matter. I hope he can have the best interests of patients in mind and come back to the right track, and let's have a rational debate and stop this unreasonable, irrational, crazy call for quorums. And lastly, I'd like to remind the pan-democrats. We've only one more meeting to go before the end of this term. We still have a bill on fire services and on private columbaria to process, and they are also related to people's livelihood. I hope they would set aside differences and do not undermine the interests of the community. They should put interests of the community at the first and foremost, and please support the bill. Thank you.
Mr. Chen Kinpo, Mr. Li Chen said Dr. Leung Ka-lau is a member representing FCs, and if you don't like what Dr. Lau has said, you should cancel FCs. I hope you will not think that one FC member will represent all FCs. Many directly elected members have caused meetings to be aborted through quorum calls. So shouldn't we therefore abolish all directly elected seats? Many FC members, such as Mr. Ma Fung Kuo, Mr. Yu Si Wing, and so on and so forth, have been doing a good job. But there are members who are disappointing in the eyes of the public. But this has got nothing to do with how they are elected. So don't put the blame on the FCs. We are facing a systemic problem. We have a problem of quorum calls. Don't blame the FCs for such problems. If we want to reflect the views of the constituency, there are more ways than asking for quorum calls. For example, there was one which will affect the insurance sector. I did some lobbying, and at the end of the day, the revised proposals was accepted to the sector. I think we should spend more time to try to set out our arguments. Things will become clarified after airing of opinion. If this is deferred to the next session, it will be passed in a few months' time. So there's no need to waste time. I think it's always better to have a debate to clarify things. I oppose to the adjournment motion. Does any other member wish to speak? Secretary for Food and Health. Point of order. I have nothing to add. Dr. Leung Ka-lau, do we have a quorum?
Okay.
梁家劉議員，你是否想打算答辯？
我會答辯。咁呢兩日聽咗好多。
In the past 2 days, I have heard many views. Yesterday, a patient representative asked me to be kind. Well, but that can mean different things. Yes, in novels and in TV drama series, sometimes we hear people say the same thing, and that has started me thinking. In these past few days, I have just passed my 30th anniversary as a doctor. I graduated on the 30th of June, 30 years ago. When I was small, I was taught by my teachers how I should treat patients, and that is, I should treat patients as if they are my parents, siblings, and that will put me in good stead. I have always remembered this, and that is why I have always treated patients as if they were my relatives. To me, this has become a habit. It is not that suddenly I have this thought, but are our parents always right? Of course not. Of course, we differ in opinion and we should communicate with them. And is it that we can do the same with patients? Yes, we can communicate with them. We can explain things to them. In the past 30 years, I have attended to thousands of patients. Talking about patients' rights, I think apart from Dr. K.K. Kwok, who is older than myself, I think even members who have taken complaints from patients would have seen fewer patients than myself. Even Mr. Wong Kwok Heng, talking about his stance on disability allowance, my attitude is still, as much as I can, I will help and do things for my patients. So if patients have to depend on one certain thought of kindness on the part of doctors, then the situation would be very bad. It is not ideal. It should not be one sudden thought of kindness. It should be the habit of doctors. It has become a habit, and so you don't even have to remember it. Secondly, I need to apologize because I used a lot of the council's time. However, I think there is an advantage. Last week, the meeting was aborted. I think Hong Kong people are becoming numbed by aborted meetings. In the past, they would assign responsibility, but they have become used to it. And I have not criticized any members. In fact, you might have helped me. And talking about the actual effect, we had one more day to do things which were more important and meaningful because the election is drawing near. Even if the meeting had not been aborted, I believe the situation would not have changed one bit. On the day the meeting was aborted, I made the best use of the time. On Thursday, it was a Thursday, and I made an appointment with Dr. Ko Wing Man to see how this can be dealt with, whether there is room for maneuver. And I, in fact, put forward many options. One, that the administration has the authority to rearrange the order of the bills. And two, perhaps we could split up the bill and incorporate those non-controversial clauses in the ordinance first and leave the controversial ones for future. Because technically this is possible, but unfortunately when I met Dr. Ko, he was very busy. He only gave me 45 minutes. At that time, I told Dr. Ko that it would be best if before the council meeting this week, it would be best if we could talk again, but he said he was too busy. It was all right, and I tried to make appointments with patients' groups through my friends. And I eventually was able to meet with an important patient representative. And in fact, we were not able to reach consensus on almost everything. But in the end, there was one thing that this patient representative asked me. He said, is it that if we take away Clause 11, then you won't filibuster anymore? At that time, I said to him, I can think about it, I said. I would have to go back and consult my constituents. In a way, our differences were narrowed. Because to this patient group, Clause 11 doesn't really matter a lot to him, because Clause 11 is about an overhaul of the mechanism to constitute a hearing of complaints. And coming back, this was not discussed at all at the Bills Committee. Some friends think that this is too rushed. Others say everything has been discussed. My personal view is it is indeed rushed. This is an important change. And at the Bills Committee, in the last meeting and near at the end, in the final 15 minutes, in fact, I still had many things that I wanted to propose, but then I knew I did not have time. So I raised this again, and the administration could not answer it, and the Bills Committee overran, and we asked for a written reply. After that, of course, I wanted another meeting because there was still time. But we had to tie in with the legislative timetable of the administration, so there were no other meetings. The changes brought about by Clause 11, well, last week and this week, was still the subject of explanation from me to members. And members still don't know what this is about. Frankly, you don't know. It is an important change. And the Bills Committee, why? Don't know whether this happens with other Bills Committee, because frankly I'm not that diligent. I apologize for that. This Bills Committee had a meeting every week for a row of 10 weeks. We were so diligent. I don't know whether we did the same with other Bills Committees. Were they as diligent? To be frank, after a meeting, the administration would have a few days to prepare for answers, and the papers would be submitted only before the next meeting. And then we criticized it. We said, how could you just table papers? We will not have time to read them, we said. And so they started to submit papers the day before the meeting. And there were only 10 weeks spent on the bill, and every week there was a meeting, and it was difficult for members to digest the issues. There was not enough time to ask follow-up questions, and also my proposed amendment to Clause 11 was, in fact, a subject the administration should attend to, but all that was not dealt with. Sorry for the digression. Where was I? So I talked to a patient representative, and our differences were narrowed, and Clause 11 doesn't have anything to do with patients, representatives, or groups, so they actually did not think that it was an important clause. Okay, the meeting was over, and I went back to consult my constituents, and they told me that Clause 11 was important, of course, but it was about the interest of the sector more, and other people might not understand it because it was very complex, and most people would only be concerned about Clause 4, and that is to add 4 lay members, and at the same time, whether we can balance those off with a same ratio of elected members from the sector, because this has to do with the public interest and whether the medical council would be maneuvered and influenced too much by, or interfered with too much by, the administration. I told the patient representative that, well, Clause 11 is important, but Clause 4 cannot be for compromise because it has to do with public interest. And then we went to City Forum. Actually, the patient representative and the official were very sincere. After the City Forum, we had a meal together. But my constituents told me that clause was important, and they told me that there was no way there could be more discussion. But then the administration said, yes, we could continue to discuss to see whether there is any room for compromise. And in the end, we achieved something. And so we said, okay, we'll take that back to consult our own party. And the administration said they would try to see whether something could be done. 2 days later, my side again met with the patient representative 1 day later. We were very busy, but then the representative came to me, what would happen to Clause 4? And he was telling me, don't just tell me what your constituents told you. Why don't you lobby them? Why don't you listen to me? Then I said, yes, we could still discuss it. And I tried to discuss Clause 11 with him. And then he went away. And 2 days later, the administration said they would not budge. So is there still room for discussion? We don't know. You can't tell. If there are loyalists who can give me 6 votes on Clause 11, since Clause 11 attracts CSAs, you need to vote whether or not Clause 11 should be incorporated into the bill. Now, when we vote on Clause 11, if you would just abstain, if I have 34 votes of abstention and opposition, and if the president would also, or chairman at that stage, would also give me the vote, then everything will be fine. Of course, I may be naive. Therefore, I would say you never know how things will evolve. Sometimes you think these adjournment motions are useless, but I think it's a kind of strategy. It's really a kind of strategy. Say, for example, before the vote is taken, well, the biggest advantage is that the fire services bill and the private columbaria bill can immediately come to this council, and maybe tomorrow before noon we would have completed scrutiny of those two bills, and then we can spend the entire next week on this one. Well, it can happen that way. If you insist today, then what other tricks can I have? Mr. Wong Yok Man says, I would not have other tricks. If we continue to dwell on this, maybe this will drag on till the end and we will achieve nothing. What else can I say? And talking about public opinion, I respect patients' rights groups' opinions. But would that equal public opinion? The patients' groups' representatives, well, never mind, I won't mention patients' groups again. But what is public opinion? Has the administration done any opinion survey? I did twice. One was a few months ago. I was trying to gauge the views of the public on the increase of lay members in the medical council. In fact, there were not a lot of strong opinions. Only 30% said yes, 30% said we could keep the status quo, and over 10% said, in fact, the number could be decreased. I commissioned the Hong Kong UPOP to do this. They are an independent third party, and they designed the questions. A few months later, and a lot of things have happened, and now what do the public think? That is why the night before yesterday, again, I asked somebody to do an opinion survey with a smaller sample. In fact, those who support an increase of lay members remained more or less the same, but in fact, the ratio came down a little. And those who supported maintaining the status quo went up by 2-3%, and those who supported a decrease also increased by 2-3%. So don't blame me for filibustering, and don't blame me for representing public opinion, because in fact that is what is shown by surveys. I did not ask for a call for quorum because I was speaking. Please sit down.
Before I put to you the question on the motion on the adjournment of the debate, I wish to remind members that in accordance with Rule 42 and 3 of the Rules of Procedure, if the motion is passed, the second reading debate on the Medical Registration Amendment Bill 2016 shall stand adjourned, and the Council shall proceed to the next item of business. If the motion is negatived, the Council shall continue the second reading debate on the bill. I now put a question to you, and that is that a motion moved by Dr. the Honourable Ka-lau under Rule 41 of the Rules of Procedure that a second reading debate on the Medical Registration Amendment Bill 2016 be now adjourned, be passed. Would those in favour please raise their hands? Mr. Chen teaching claims a division. The division bell will ring for 5 minutes. Thank you.
Voting begins. Members, please verify your votes. If there is no question, voting is closed. The results are displayed. From functional constituencies, 28 present, 4-4, 23 against. From geographical constituencies, 28 present, 8-4, 20 against. The question is not agreed by a majority of each of two groups of members present. This council will now continue the second reading debate on the Medical Registration Amendment Bill 2016. Does any member wish to speak?